addition to what you see in the program, I'll be playing all three movements of the Handel Concerto after the Sowerby. I hope you enjoy this little taste of early 20th century.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
Thank you for being here. My name is Tom Lloyd. I have the honor of being the canon for music and the arts here at the Cathedral, as well as director of the Bucks County Choral Society. And so it gives me great pleasure to bring together my two beloved communities. The choir has come from over an hour away in Doylestown. And the special occasion is that this is the first time in 2 years that a large choir has sung in this space, and the first time that it has any large choir has performed with our newly restored and magnificent organ. Thank you. And while in-person audiences are not as large as they were beforehand, we know that right this moment we have a large live streaming audience of people not only in this region but around the country who are connected to us in one way or another. And we're very pleased that you're with us, and we thank Joe Hannigan and his crew for making it possible to make that a seamless transition. It's important for me also to thank the foundation that made this organ possible, the Wincoat Foundation, and especially Fred Haas and Rafael Gomez for their leadership in bringing this organ to the cathedral. We believe that it is, yes. We have been coming to know and love it over the last several months since we began worshiping in person, and now concerts are beginning to happen. We believe that it is one of the finest combinations of acoustic and organ in our great city. And we're looking forward to many groups after us coming back who regularly sing here, Singing City, Mendelssohn Club, Philadelphia Chorus, the Philadelphia Gay Pride Chorus, conducted by Dan Schwartz, as well as groups like Pifaro and Tempesta di Mare, are beginning to come back and perform in the space, and now we'll have this magnificent instrument to perform with. Just a word about the program. The program is in two halves. We're in a time where it seems more apparent than ever that things in our world are beyond any one of our individual capacities to understand or control, and that the best we have is our connection to each other individually and in community. Now, people in religious traditions have focused on this issue, and there are two polarities that they look at, and coming in this case from our particular traditions of the French Catholic tradition of Vierne and the Anglican English tradition of all the anthem composers. In common, they have a visionary way of thinking of organ and choir together on an equal basis with a great deal of imagination beyond what had been done before. This is a very unique tradition, and they're different, the French and the English, but they are very simpatico, as you will hear. And the polarities that they're dealing with are transcendence and immanence. Transcendence being our sense of the vastness of the universe, how much larger it is than anything that we can imagine. And religious people in various religious traditions find ways of understanding this, and in the Christian tradition, music is one of the main ways that they reach for that. So in the first half, you'll hear a number of pieces that are very celebratory in nature, ecstatic in nature, and at the same time, you'll hear Herbert Howell's "Like as the Heart Desireth the Water Brooks" in the middle of all that celebration, with a sense of the feeling of being alone in that vastness and wondering where, as the psalmist says, where is now thy God? On the second half is more about immanence. Immanence, the sense of connection to what religious people call the divine, what other people may call something, a larger thing than just ourselves. And here, the music is much more ruminative in nature. The opening anthem is Bainton's evocation of a new heaven and a new earth from the book of Revelation. The idea that all the confusion will somehow be something that we will be able someday to transcend because of the imminent embrace of God, which we feel in this anthem. It literally feels like a warm musical embrace. The two movements from Vierne's Mass, his Sanctus Benedictus and the Agnus, are very subdued, much more subdued than the usual interpretations of these pieces. And he wanders off into very strange keys, harmonic areas where you wonder, what is he thinking? Where is his imagination going? A great deal of uncertainty, again, searching for that connection. The evening hymn of Gardner, Raphael Gardner, in the middle of that, is an outcry for protection, which is answered with a sense of the fierce love of the divine. And then finally, we conclude with Hurd's generous interpretation of Ubi Caritas, wherever love is, there God is also. Again, that sense of closeness to something far larger than ourselves. With that in mind, I would invite you in the first half to applaud freely at the end of each selection, because part of ecstatic music is to join in the applause, join in the energy, and complete the piece. And then I would invite you in the second half to withhold your applause, allow the silence between the pieces to speak themselves until the end of the wonderful Vidor finale that Tim will play at the end. And with that, I'll hand it over to our wonderful accompanist, Tim Harrell.